Good Saturday evening, everybody, live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austen, Onek with a quick check of your forecast. Things a lot quieter than what they were just about a week ago or so. We're looking again at a little bit of drizzle for this evening. We're looking at the possibility of maybe a rumble of thunder tonight, but really not much more than that. And as we get into the course of the rest of the next couple of days, we're looking at the possibility of some pretty soggy weather out there. So if you have any plans for outdoors, looking again at the possibility of seeing, again, a lot more in the way of indoor weather than anything else. So if you have any plans for outdoors, definitely want to plan ahead for that. If you are just in town from the area in and around the Mid-South, North Mississippi, West Tennessee, or Eastern Arkansas, drop your location, wherever you happen to be, drop your location into the comments section. Let's see some weather information on there, and we'll give everybody an idea as to what's going on wherever you might happen to be for tonight. And again, if you got that thermometer outside the kitchen window, let us know a little bit more about what's going on there. If you can't stick around for the whole forecast tonight, that's great. We take a lot of time to let people know what the forecast is, give opportunity to ask questions and things like that. But if you can't stick around, that's perfectly cool because you got the forecast at the bottom of your screen in the blue bar down there scrolling along. And if you can't get enough weather from that, go to this website address at wreg.com/weather where you can get the 7 to 10 day forecast. And that's all available again as well, all lined up and ready to go for you out there. Looking at some pretty soggy conditions out there. We'll talk more about what the forecast is going to look like coming up here in just a little bit. So stick around for more of that. Also, more of your weather pictures in just a little while. Coming up into tomorrow morning, again, the possibility of some fairly chilly conditions, maybe a few numbers in the mid to upper 30s out there, but mainly lower 40s for the metro, and more chances of rain throughout the rest of the evening. Best chances of rain will be overnight into tomorrow, and then we should see a slow and steady drawback of the rainfall. Then maybe some more rainfall coming our way after President's Day. We'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little bit. Thanks to everybody for checking in tonight. 39 in Moscow, Tennessee. Christy B. Beretta, welcome to the show. 39 degrees in South Haven. Kelly Mansfield, thank you very much for that one. Holmes Beach, Florida. Sue Dodd Mall. Hope it's a little bit warmer down there than what it is up here. Thank you very much for that. John Michael, 39 degrees in Bartlett. Thank you. And William Skage, 22 in the Motor City. A little chilly up north. Thank you very much for that one. Lot chilly here in the area with numbers just below normal. Should be in the mid-50s at this time of the year. We're nearly 15 degrees colder than that throughout the entire day. Now, officially, no rain came down today, but we're still ahead for the year, about almost 2 inches or so. So that's very good news in the long term out there. Mississippi River, again, a little drizzly out there for tonight. Big River Crossing doing its thing as a top of the hour animation should be wrapping up here in the next few minutes. But the Mississippi River is high and going to be going a lot more upstairs in the next several days. 28 feet is considered what's called action stage, and that means that farmland and roads around the Mississippi and the Memphis area in certain locations are starting to flood. As you get closer to 34 feet, that's called minor flooding, and that's again where the numbers get a little bit higher. The water goes a little bit farther back toward the levees around West Memphis, Arkansas. This is not looking like a few years ago where we had like the top five flooding going on, knocking some of the 1920s and 30s floods out of here, but it is still heading upwards. It's not expected to crest until we get into next week, and that forecast depends on what happens with more rainfall coming up. Now, does this mean that Mud Island and downtown and West Memphis are in mortal danger and are going to be flooded out and just totally underwater? No, it doesn't come close to that. But it is going to be, again, a possibility of seeing Big River Crossing close down on the Arkansas side of things. We'll keep you updated on that over the next several days, so keep it tuned to News Channel 3, and we'll keep you updated on all of that for right now. Alan Shump, welcome from Atlanta, Georgia, and have a safe trip back to South Haven tomorrow. Thank you very much for that one. 38 degrees, Horn Lake, Brandy Jean Ramey, welcome to the show. Thank you very much for that. Randy Henson, a oldie but a goodie, your mud is getting dehydrated. Ha ha, thank you very much for that good one on there. Thought I'd heard them all before. 34 degrees, Rochester, Lachey has no time to play Walker. Thank you very much for that. And Paulette Morrow, 35 degrees and rain in New Bern, Tennessee. Thank you very much for the reports out there. 240, again, is shut down in both directions as the last scheduled update occurs for the TDOT construction area right here. Again, that's scheduled construction. Unscheduled repair work could happen at any point in time, but for this weekend, I-240 in both directions is shut down. Now, last weekend, Park Avenue was shut down. You should be able to see some traffic out there. May not be able to with, again, the trains in the way. But, again, Park Avenue is open this weekend. It's just 240 is not. So if you're planning on heading anywhere through and between, again, the flyover all the way down to Bill Morris Parkway, anything in this area at this level, see, there we go, wrong roadway. There we go. That's what we're looking at for right there. Flyover down to Bill Morris Parkway. That is closed off at this point in time on 240, but all the east-west roadways across here are still open, so good news on that. Had one round of rainfall move on through, and there's not really a lot left of it for right now. Now, back to the north of us, we're getting some sleet and snow mixed together over parts of southern Missouri. We're not seeing any major problems. Definitely not like what we saw in parts of Missouri around I-70 on Friday. If you'd like to see that incredibly scary video, go to my Facebook page and you'll see a lot more about what that looked like. Now, down to the south of us, that's where the heaviest amount of rainfall has been coming in and moving, skirting the Mid-South area back to the southern parts there. A few scattered showers just about out of the Mid-South, and we're not quite done just yet. We've had what's left of an atmospheric river coming in off the Pacific, and we're going to be tapping into more moisture coming up from the Gulf of Mexico in the next day or so. Rainy day tomorrow. Much more rain heading our way. Parts of the southern United States could see, again, inches of rainfall, and we're looking again at maybe some flash flooding going on there. Numerous winter advisories north of us, not for the Mid-South, but again, winter weather advisories in the purple, winter storm warnings in the blue, well back up to our north at this point in time. So we are seeing, again, some dangerous travel conditions up here. So if you're heading anywhere, say, I-70 and northward, you may want to think about some extra time to get to where you're going and calling ahead, checking the weather up that direction to see what's happening with your destination just to be on the safe side out there for right now. Welcome to everybody who's checking in for tonight on a fairly dreary evening across much more of the area for right now. Roger Adams, how high is the water out there? Three, yeah, that's good. That's an oldie but a goodie too. Thank you very much for that one. If you'd like to see more about that, you can go to our website for more details, again, about what's going on with the river, wreg.com/weather for more information there. Again, welcome to everybody checking on through. Drop your location, city, state, and your temperature reports or your weather reports out there. Let's see what's going on at everybody's location in tune around the area 4 right now. Temperatures on WeatherNet 3, live real-time weather showing upper 30s to lower 40s, and winds occasionally gusty, but not seeing a lot of problems right now with about 5 miles per hour or so. Memphis International, a little more breezy at about 10 miles per hour there. All right, running the numbers into overnight, what we're going to be looking for is going to be the possibility of these scattered showers continuing. The computer models for the short term are starting to show a little bit more buildup overnight, and the Storm Prediction Center is placing a possibility of some thunderstorms out there. So toward early Sunday morning, I-40 on either side in Tennessee, North Mississippi, Eastern Arkansas, I would not be surprised to hear a rumble of thunder out there and maybe a flash of lightning, but so far we're not detecting anything. Overnight there could be, again, that stray chance of a shower or a thunderstorm into the area, but outside of that overnight, that should be just about it. Now, into tomorrow morning, chances of showers continue across much of the area. Winds will be turning around from the south, and that's going to help to kind of keep the temperatures up by just a little bit. Not by much, but it will be above freezing, so that's some good news out there. And then tomorrow, the winds start coming in from out of the west. Why is that significant? Well, because that's drier air coming in from off the continent, and that is going to erode the rainfall and hopefully some of the cloud cover. So high temperatures tomorrow, a little warmer than today, very close to normal across much of the Mid-South area. And then as we get into Sunday evening, clearing skies back to the west of us, cloudy skies for much of the Mid-South, and the rest of those showers should be on their way out of here as we go into Sunday night, which should begin to give us a decently dry, if not mostly cloudy, Monday across much of the area out there. Michael Farmer, 37 degrees, cloudy in Hillsboro, Tennessee. Thank you very much for that one and for everybody else checking in. Now, over the next several days, the Weather Prediction Center is showing the potential. Well, it did have it there, unfortunately, for a second, with the possibility of more rainfall. What we're going to be looking for here, using my own inadequate artwork to show that the best possibility of the heaviest amount of rainfall is going to be mainly back to our west, or to our east. And again, the heaviest rainfall from southeastern Tennessee through northeastern parts of Mississippi could be about 3 to 5 inches here. And on top of saturated soil, that water just runs off, heads into the culverts, and that can make rivers and streams rise pretty rapidly. Now, again, the good news is this is targeted away from the News Channel 3 viewing area, but if this starts to get a little bit more showers heading our direction, we could be looking at heavier rainfall in the course of the next couple of days. Doesn't look like a flash flooding situation right now, but this is definitely something to watch out for in the course of the next several days, so keep it tuned for more on that with News Channel 3. Fog into tomorrow morning. Could be some patchy fog out there, registering the ice 40 quarter as seeing the possibility of some fog below 1 mile. If that happens, we'll let you know coming up on News Channel 3 Daybreak, so stay tuned for more on that. We'll keep you updated there. Rest of the area for tonight, again, temperatures again dropping into the upper 30s, lower 40s. High temperatures tomorrow in the mid to upper 50s, with showers beginning to dwindle into tomorrow evening. President's Day, the holiday, looking again dry, but it's going to be a cooler one. Temperatures about a category lower than Sunday in the mid to upper 40s. Staying cool on Tuesday. Rain chances really start to ramp up as we go throughout the day, and showers remain in the Mid-South, widespread into Tuesday evening. We'll warm up a little bit by midweek. Shower potential sticks around. Also for Thursday, as temperatures again cool off by just a bit, another surge of warm air comes in here as we head toward the weekend, so we could be pushing 70 degrees by the time we hit next Saturday. Afterwards, again, leveling off the temperatures, but this is going to be above normal, so it's not exactly cooler specifically. What I'm more concerned about is going to be this potential here Saturday night into next Sunday of maybe some stronger weather heading our way. It is way too early to tell at this point what we may be looking at, but again, this is something that we do need to see again. The possibility of what we could be seeing is stronger weather coming on through. And when signs like that show up this far in advance, kind of makes you sit up and take notice by just a little bit, and that's where we see, again, the potential for, again, maybe something stronger, definitely something to, again, to pay attention to for right now. Kathy Armstrong, the general idea of what I was drawing on there was just the fact that the heaviest rainfall was going to be back to our south and east, but that chance of rainfall, the greatest chance, could be wandering into the mid-south. And that's what we really need to pay attention to. So keep it tuned to us, and we'll help you, give you an idea as to what's going on into and around the area over the course of the next couple of days. So for right now, temperatures decently mild, a little cooler at times, but not bad. No Arctic blast, no polar vortex heading our direction, so that's good news. A little chilly at times. Again, not seeing a lot of major problems. Could be close to freezing early Monday morning, but with no precipitation, I'm not really worried about this for right now. This right here has my interest, and that's something we'll be keeping our eyes on over the next several days. We lost the Opportunity rover this week. The mission was officially declared over after a dust storm in June covered over the rover's panels. It could not recharge. It could not keep warm. And with temperatures like this around the Martian surface, it needed those batteries to stay cold during those dust storms and the long Martian winters. So again, this is something that is really kind of cool to take a look at. Weather from the fourth rock from the sun, this from the Curiosity rover, and the last time we had a weather check-in from the rover on Wednesday the 13th, the maximum temperature was 1 degree above zero, not freezing, but above zero Fahrenheit, and a minimum temperature of negative 97. Again, that's not exactly the worst it can get out there, but for air temperatures, it wasn't bad. The ground holds a little bit more heat, so the temperature is a little bit warmer here, 41 degrees, but at nighttime and when the sun goes down and in the winter season, you can get some pretty nasty cold conditions on the surface. So these things, those rovers, have to be very, very hardy to survive that environment, not to mention a whole bunch of ultraviolet radiation coming on through. So that's an important thing. If you'd like to get this information, it's readily available to you. Just go to mars.nasa.gov and you can check up on the health of the rovers, and also the other missions that are out there, including the InSight probe, which is measuring the fourth rock from the sun to see if there are such things as Mars quakes. Really cool to take a look at. Exometeorology, that's the term for weather on study of weather on other planets. So really cool to take a look and see what's available to us out there with that technology. What's available to us on this planet, if you'd like to know more about it, is severe weather. And again, if you'd like to know more about what to do ahead of time, this week starts the spring semester of classes being taught by the National Weather Service in Memphis. If you'd like to know more, again, it's very easy to do so. Go to weather.gov. Click on the map or go to weather.gov/MEG. That's the three-letter designator for the National Weather Service in Memphis. First two meetings will be this Tuesday, the 19th at 6:30 p.m., one in Senatobia, another one in Boonville. The next one after that will be this Thursday at Henning, Tennessee, and the next one after that will be next Monday, the 25th. Not this Monday, but the one after that, the 25th in Pontotoc, Mississippi. These are just the first four meetings. There's about a baker's dozen of these things. You show up, you take the course, you get more informed about what needs to be done before, during, and after severe weather. It's a really good opportunity to learn more about what happens before severe weather hits. You might have just moved to this area and maybe you've never been in a tornado warning before. It's nice to know what may happen and how you can get ready for that, and this is what these classes will teach you all about. Now, again, two things. This is a volunteer position, so for the kids out there, you might be thinking, and I've had this happen in several classrooms, saying, oh, great, I can get paid for this. No, volunteer work here, but it looks awfully good on a resume when you're trying to get work later on to show that you set aside time for your community to help keep everybody safe. The other thing about this is it is a spotter training course, and there's probably going to be comments out there that says, well, no kidding, it says that right there. Besides, we know the difference between spotters and chasers. A lot of people don't. They're not the same thing. If you're going to chase storms, you need to be highly trained. You do not chase storms unless you have been trained by experts. Period. End of sentence. Don't argue with me on this. It's very important. We need more spotters out there chasing. You can do that when you get trained for it. Spotters, if you can look, listen, and report that information back to the National Weather Service, your information can help save lives. That's the important thing. So please, please consider becoming a Skywarn spotter. Again, totally free, paid for by your tax dollars and my tax dollars. Show up, take the course, ask questions, have a great time. National Weather Service will be teaching these throughout the next several weeks. So stay tuned to News Channel 3, and we'll keep you updated on that. Cheryl Lockhart 6, our only submission for weather pictures this week on Twitter. Nice view of the stars out there and what looks to be Orion in the background out there. So thank you very much for some nice illuminated clouds at night. If you've got weather pictures, we'd love to see them and show them, but we can't do that if you don't send them in. So please consider, you got the snapshots, tweet them to me, post them on my Facebook page, or again, another great way to get them to me, email them to me at austin.onek@wreg.com. Would love to share your pictures around. Again, if you got weather pictures around the Mid-South, that's what we're concentrating on, but you got stuff of you doing stuff in the weather as well. Good opportunity for you to take that advantage too and get your pictures out there. So thank you very much to everybody else who has sent those out there. Catch my forecast on the radio throughout the rest of the weekend on Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3. Bells, Tennessee, Lisa Williams Frazee, hope I'm saying that right, from Bells, Tennessee, 37. And Willie E. Standback, 39 degrees in North Haven. Thank you very much for those weather reports there. Rest of the evening, again, a little chilly, temperatures in the mid to upper 30s to lower 40s, but not doing too bad out there. At least we're just looking at showers, nothing in the way of winter weather, so definitely some good news on that. I'll have a complete check of your forecast coming up on News Channel 3 at 10, and of course I'll be on with News Channel 3 Daybreak bright and early at 6 a.m., so stay tuned for more on that. Questions, concerns, ideas, anything you got that you would like to see on our weather reports here, give us a shout. Again, email me at austin.onek@wreg.com, and would love to hear from you on there. And, of course, got plenty to do on our social media network, so stay tuned there, and also at wreg.com/weather. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Stay tuned for much more with News Channel 3 throughout the rest of the weekend on air and online. And again, thanks for joining us for Weather Overtime for Saturday night.